Greetings, Earthlings! You know how when really bad things happen in your life just kind of tends to just flash before your eyes? Like when I saw the scalpel coming out to take the huge section out of the roof of my mouth for surgery a couple of weeks ago, my life just flashed before my eyes. It took a full half a second. I mean, yeah, I have quite the life. As we're all about to witness, I have no life, and the fact that it took half a second was a miracle. Today, we're going to go through this day in history in all of the journals that I have for the past, starting in 2012. I do have some entries from 2011, but not for August 6th, which is today. For once, I'm actually filming the video on the day then which I intend to post it. So, without further ado, we are going to start in 2012 with August 6th. Some of these are probably pretty awkward. Okay. Now, in a lot of, well, actually every other one of my old diaries, I used to write something other than Dear Diary, like Yo Diary, depending on the day, different ones. And as it turns out, those were all the summer diaries, and all the ones that have regular Dear Diary were the fall diaries. So a lot of these are going to have really weird phrases in them. This one is Hiya Diary. It says, way too much math today. Two is spelt like not correctly. My head feels like it's exploding. I can't wait for Wednesday, even though we probably will have to do school in the morning and maybe skip the pool. I guess we're going to the pool on Wednesday. I hope we don't. That would be so great. Oh man, Mom just came in and turned off our big light. She thinks it gets too hot. Again, two is incorrectly spelled. Now there's only one tiny light on, and Miss Tasteless is hoarding it so that I can't see. That's my entire diary entry. And my handwriting, as you can see, is pretty hideous. Now, for another reference, or as you saw on the thumbnail of this video, this is a photo that was in this diary of what I looked like at the time that I wrote it. Look at that picture. That's what I looked like. I don't even look female. To all of you people who have heard me say, oh, I didn't really look female when I was a kid, this is your proof. Okay? I didn't. Alright, moving on to 2013. Like, all of these entries are really short at first because you can tell these journals. Did I show the other one? I can't remember. It was Hello Kitty with a cupcake. These were the first two. And then in 2013, things weren't much better because I had Wonder Woman. And I thought to bookmark some of these for myself. This one says, Achoo Diary. My allergies were a lot better today, but I'm still sneezing with abandon. Today we finished the bear's side garden and did their back patio. We were weeding for the neighbors. That was our job. My sister and I, we were doing weeding. We visited Aunt Eva, where I took pictures of her for Mom to email to Aunt Terry. Don't ask me why. And I watched The Chew, where Mario admitted to saying the F word in the presence of a queen. This is really diary-worthy news. Yikes. They also showed a handy lock you can put on ice cream cartons to keep other people from stealing it. Nice! I also got roped into watching the Hardy Boys, took pictures to sell to Sarah, and took a video of her singing to Do Run Run, and then I went nuts. You see why. Hey Sarah, are you still around? I just got to an entry about you singing to Do Run Run! She was very obsessed with Sean Cassidy in this years. Don't understand what that is, or you didn't watch the Hardy Boys, you can look it up. It's pretty awkward. And I think I had a collection on Google Plus a few years ago, so you can just go and open that. This is my diary from the next year, 2015? No, 14. I was gonna say, did I miss a year? No. This is my diary in 2015. And actually, August 6th didn't land on a regular day in this diary. It actually landed on the first entry in this diary, so it's an introduction to the diary. Now, for several years, I did an introduction to my diaries, where I would like, let's just see, make it like a little novel or something. Well, not like a novel, but like, I don't know, some type of introduction to my life because I'm trying to make these more interesting as it goes on. But then we get into a point where I'm like on my 12th diary and I'm just like, you know who I am! And I don't do that anymore. This one says, hi! This is probably the last time I'll start an entry with hi. It looks stupid. My name, my whole name, the first name that I refuse to use, and my last name, which I also don't like. Fill in the blank with Rose, even though I didn't start using Rose until 2016. So just fill in the blank with Rose. Hi, I'm Rose, and I'll be writing in you every day for the foreseeable future. I'm 15 years old, and I live with my mother, a devout Hebrew roots Christian who dreams of moving to Israel, and our little sister Sarah, who in addition to her numerous mental issues, previous diaries chronicle her famed Sean Cassidy obsession, as was mentioned, she's also an England nut. Case in point, we went shopping today and she got a Union Jack blanket for her bed and an England-themed t-shirt. In fact, England-themed t-shirts are about all she'll wear, and as soon as the weather gets cooler, she plans to paint her room red, white, and blue with a flag on one wall and a Doctor Who mural on the other. She actually did do that, and then last summer out of the blue, she decided she was bored. She wanted to paint her room black and white instead, and we had to paint over all that work. I could go on to list all the other things I put in the front of my diaries, but that would be too depressing. So I'll tell you instead some good news. I got two pairs of Daddy's Money sneakers for $20 today. Yahoo! Those were those, Skechers made them, but they weren't really Skechers. They had this, like, heel in the back, and they came in these all wild colors. I still have a bunch of those. I haven't worn them in a while because ever since I injured my foot, I'm not supposed to be wearing high-heeled sneakers all the time. I used to wear them back then a lot. Okay, so moving on to 2015. 15, yeah. got these charming little warnings in the front of my diary of what I'm going to do to people who read it, and then I just sit down on the internet and read it to everyone. Sorry if I'm not making interesting enough commentary. What happened to the last video is it ran so long that my camera separated it into two clips, and then I couldn't put them back together, and I'm trying not to run that long this time, so sorry if it's too, like, rushed or whatever, but you still get to hear all the cringiness. Okay, where is August 6th? Okay. This morning I got right out of bed when I heard the click that precedes the touch of frost music on the famous alarm clock without waiting for the actual music to start. I put away all my bedding, then did my weights workout and went for two bike rides before breakfast. After breakfast I went for my last bike ride, washed my hair, and changed my t-shirt to go to the library. That's why we got up at 6, we wanted to spend the morning there, and we didn't want Mom to complain that she had to wait for us to finish all our stuff before she drove us there. I remember that. I spend most of the time there working on that PJ story that I started last month. Yeah, I know, I've been slacking off. It was meant to be a no-pressure story to write during vacation anyway. I'll have it finished before it's time to start school, I hope. This is a couple of things that'll never happen again. Back when I was an actual writer, and I didn't just write one novel a year for NaNoWriMo. And back when I actually had to do school, which I don't have to. And I wrote 10 pages, and I also looked over Sarah's shoulder while she used the library computer. We were both greatly disappointed to learn that you can find word etymologies on the internet, and I was disappointed to see Lucas North posters and iPhone cases. Like, feel disappointed. And drew colored pictures like an idiot. Oh, I drew in colored pictures like an idiot. All I can say is that A, I hope they don't save the CCTV camera footage, and B, I'm glad the Russos didn't show up unexpectedly. Those are some people I used to know, and I didn't like to look like an idiot in front of them. When we got home, me and Sarah filmed the rest of a miscellaneous episode we started yesterday, which featured pizza and a fat-butted scoundrel, since today is International Fat-Butted Scoundrel Day. This is not a real person, this was a stuffed animal that we had. That we were using in our videos. Yeah, I know, we were 16 years old when we were doing this. Well, she was 14, but whatever. And what we used to do was, we used to film this cooking show with this character, Miss Elaine. She used to play the character, and I would play the cameraman, who had, like, a bit of dialogue with them, but mostly I would just film her, and she would cook things. When she was younger, she used to take all of her food and, like, make recipes out of the food on her plate, and I would film that. And then when she got older, she started getting into, like, making up her own recipes using cookbooks and stuff. And then, so by now, like, she would just, there was a short period of time where she used cookbooks, but then she pretty much went from playing with her food to playing with everyone's food and just inventing recipes herself. And now she makes a bunch of really gross vegan, gluten-free stuff. Anyway, we haven't filmed Miss Elaine in years, but this is the kind of thing Miss Elaine would be proud of. Then I read and ate dinner, went for another long walk with the aforementioned sister, and we watched McLeod's Daughters until Mom really wanted to go to bed. After this, me and Sarah plan to head outside. So yeah. So a lot of times, I do just chronicle my day, talking about what I did that day, as you can see. The entries, they really do kind of read like a book. Like, I'll talk about reoccurring themes in my life and emotional stuff, but not every single day that I write, because I do write every single day. So, it's really, if you pick one date, are you going to get a juicy entry that says something really dramatic? Probably not. So yeah, most of them are just, like, chronologically, this is what I did today. Although I noticed I exercised way more back then than I do now, which kind of makes me feel like a slump. But I try. Okay. August 6th. Man, I'm hungry. As I sit here, I was half reading the first At Home in Mitford book. I never finished that series. My mom said it was good and I read part of it and it was so boring. I was just like, Mom, why? This is just about a bunch of old people. Then the old people have an old people romance. Like, okay. Romance is horrifying enough, but if you're over 60, it's a no-go zone. I was half daydreaming about my breakfast. Well, split that into thirds because I was also trying to ignore the loud and annoying movie Sarah is watching, the gist of which is some gadabout sex-loving Earl is actually the writer of Shakespeare's plays. And there was an unfortunate scene with a good chunk of the St. Crispin's Day speech in it, which Sarah, of course, delighted to recite along with them. Now, in case you wonder why I'm struggling so much to read my own writing, this is what it now looks like. It's as messy as it was, but now it's really, really tiny. So it can be a little difficult. And I'm sorry about all that stuff last night. I really should stop writing that crap in here. Oh, so clearly the day before I had a big traumatic thing. I can't help but notice that back on May 12th, I said I was going to shut this box a bit and move on. Yeah. I'm just gonna skip that line. Today was a pretty good day. I slept until 9 on the couch because I was sleeping over with Sarah, but then it was too hot and quiet on her floor and I was dreaming some pretty wacky dreams. I finished reading Jeremiah. I listened to Mom read the Torah portion. Oh, it's Saturday. It's Sabbath for the Torah portion. I was gonna say, what? And then I watched a few kitty cartoons. You had to know I would get that in somewhere. And I ate my one meal for the day. Again. What was with me? All I did was exercise and eat one meal for the day. Why was I not dead? And then I lost my place. We did worship, and Steve dispelled the myth that one must be baptized to be saved, and we finally discovered how Jason's been making mysterious holes in the tops of his sneakers. Apparently, he sticks his feet under the mat in the van on his way to day program and rubs his toes on the rough side. I actually discovered that. I was proud of myself. One of our friends that comes over for church at our house, which we called worship here, we always call it worship, he would always, like, wear a hole in his sneaker, and we couldn't figure out how he was doing it, and his mom thought that it was his, like, he was rubbing it from the other side with his toe, I thought about it, and I was just like, you know what, he's gotta be doing it from the other side, and I had recently vacuumed the car and saw the spiky spikes on the bottom of the mat, and I was just like, is there a mat like that in the van that he rides in? Because if there is, that could be how he's doing it. But, yeah, that wasn't necessary. I'm not sure why I wrote it in my diary, except it was just a triumph to be the one who figured that mystery out. And then I worked on my PJ story, and I got 3 whole pages done in an hour. I went for a walk, and I hung around reading. I plan to watch a movie, too, when Sarah stops using the telly. And I'm not even going to look at my phone all night. Quite the achievement, hee hee. Yeah, back when I actually spent time away from my phone. I thought that I was being pious. Okay, that was 2016. This is the last entry. This is from 2017. And I don't have one from today because I haven't written it yet. And even if I did, I don't think I'd read it because it's a little awkward to read the one that I just wrote. I was like, that's kind of private. I don't mind reading one from like 2 years ago or last year, but that's awkward. And there's also not a bookmark in this one, so bear with me. Oh, here we go. August 6th. They say that you should try new things every day. So today, I used the key to the bear's house to clean the grass out of the lawnmower blades, and it worked like a charm. So I guess the elusive they were onto something there. Anywho, today I slept until 6:45. I woke up out of hunger, I think, or because Mum was noisily pouring water in the kitchen, or possibly both. A lot of times in the summer, I'm sleeping out in the living room because my room gets so hot, and we only have the one crappy air conditioner, so it's a necessity for me to sleep out in the living room, which is attached to the kitchen, so. You get noise. And then I laid in my sleeping bag a bit until after 7, reading my Bible and looking at my phone. Then I got up and went off in search of breakfast. After 3 rice cakes, 2 waffles, fruit, and a cookie, I still wasn't that full, but I quit anyway. After I ate, we did Bible study and did the grocery shopping, and then I went for a 7.6-mile bike ride. I texted Noah a bit and did a couple arm workout videos and a legs and butt video down in the basement. It was pretty cool for August today, so I wasn't really sweaty. So I just deodorized and put a hat on over my ugly hair instead of showering again. Then I went and watched a few episodes of Good Mythical Morning on YouTube, and then Mom took Sarah and I to the mall, where we searched out a nicely scented perfume that I'm not allergic to. I got two different little bottles in yummy fall scents. Incidentally, I actually have to go back to the mall tonight to do the exact same thing, because I don't want to take like a big bottle of perfume on the airplane and get gigged for that, so I need another small one. It's just kind of weird that like a year later I'm going to be doing the exact same thing on the exact same day. That's really awkward. And I got a glass screen protector to put over the crack in my phone. I finally got a new phone yesterday. This is my new phone compared to my old phone, which is actually still over there. It's not totally dead. It's just really, really slow and the storage is full. But, and it has a huge crack in the screen. But it's like, using it today, I was like, wow, this screen. It's so bright. It's so new. It's so crackless. Because I've had the crack for a year. And then we came back and I was getting hungry, so I had fruits and vegetables for dinner. And then I went to mow the lawn. I did everything but the side yard because all the apples everywhere were bad enough, but that big dead squirrel was the deal breaker. I remember that. That was disgusting. That weird thing kept happening last summer where we just kept finding random dead animals in our yard. And they weren't like roadkill. They didn't have marks on them. They were just dead. It's like, we never put out poison. Our whole garden is organic. How are we having so many dead animals in our yard? Luckily, it didn't happen this year. After that, I watered and deadheaded Mrs. B's flowers, and then I came back home to watch America's Funniest Home Videos and look at Google Plus a little bit more before coming over to write this. And now I look ahead at tonight, tomorrow, and the rest of the week. I'm not too eager to start school. I'm not too eager to have Sarah around all the time. I'm not saying she's annoying, just that out of the 5 times that somebody referred to me marrying Noah today, 3 of them were her. Praise the Lord that time in my life is over, and that nobody can make comments about that anymore. That it's not me anymore. Yeah, she was having like 3 weeks off her summer job, I think, like she is now, in between working at summer camp and working at the preschool. So, yeah. Of course, now I'm not even going to be here for the whole time that she's off, so it's like, bye, Sarah. No, I get along with her, I'm kidding. I'm sad this is the last month of summer. And I really hope we get to go to the beach a lot in the coming season. And now for tonight. I have notifications to read and TV to watch. So yeah. So yeah, I didn't deal with that day either. So, there you go. You got some pretty boring days, but that's the crapshoot when you just randomly pick one date and not go through looking for more juicy stuff than that. And don't forget this accident gawk that you got to have. That was fun. Actually, hang on 1 second. Because I didn't plan this, but you know, there are some more pictures in this diary, and I'm just gonna have a look and see if there are any really horrifying ones, because I bet there are. Just check, because what I would do is I would take pictures of things that kind of went with the diary, and I would put them in. And okay, this is a super zoom shot of my neighbor. He was famous in diaries years ago. Another super zoom shot of it. Another, oh my goodness, why are there so many super zoom shots of my neighbor? This is my old nemesis, Julia. She's one of the Brusos. She acted like how she looks in this picture. Oh my goodness. Okay, yes. This is a picture of me. I don't know how well you can see this or any of them, because it's kind of dark, and it's kind of dark in here. But yeah, I'm hanging out on the swing set. And picture me with an axe. Oh my golly. That's, wow. I don't have a lot of pictures of me in that one. Okay. Alright, well, have a nice day, Earthlings. I hope that was at least a tiny bit interesting. And I will see you back with another video on Friday.